Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Gore Mountain. The women's parallel giant slalom medals are going to be decided. The weather is pretty grey, pretty overcast, but the track is in reasonable shape. It's had a lot of riding on it this morning with the two-run qualification, but there's been 45 minutes to an hour or so of work done to smooth the track out and ensure it's in perfect condition. Well, there's a decent crowd building here at Gore Mountain for the penultimate day of competition at these 2023 FISU World University Games in Lake Placid. But today the snow has disappeared. We were hoping for a little bit of sunshine, but it's sun hasn't broken through. Maybe tomorrow. Wouldn't it be great to finish the final day of these World University Games with some sunshine? We'll get a look at the top qualifiers. Nadia Hapitan from Ukraine qualified through in third place. In second place, it was Carmen Kainz from the University of Linz in Austria. She jumped up a huge number of places on that after that second run. But Olimpia Kwiatkowska from the Pedagogical University of Krakow in Poland. There are four quarterfinals for the women. Yang against Fava, Bondaruk against Murata. Murata, the surprise package, knocking out the number one seed, Kwiatkowska from Poland, who had some one or two issues, it's fair to say, in the eight finals. And if you get through this one, you know that a medal is almost within reach, because if you make it into the semi-finals, even if you lose your semi-final, you go into the small final where you can race four positions, three and four, in that final spot on the podium here at Gore Mountain. So next up, quarterfinal one for the women. Elisa Fava from Italy on the blue. Siho Yang from Korea on the red. Yang, the number four seed. Fava, the number five seed. So here we go, a place in the semi-finals up for grabs. Siho Yang on the red course, Fava on the blue. Great start from the Italian on the blue course. But now Yang starts to come back into this race. Gets a little closer to Fava. Can Fava hold off the challenge of the Korean, who just gets the board a little bit sideways? Can the Italian get through into the semi-final? She does, Elisa Fava, by just over half a second. Through into the semi-finals, and a medal now within reach for Italy. The number five seed knocking out the number four seed. Well, a close race there. And Elisa Fava doing a wonderful job to get in to the semi-finals. Top four result guaranteed for her. So who is Elisa Fava going to be racing against in that first semi-final? Noa Murata on the blue course, up against Vita Bodnaruk from Ukraine on the red. Murata, the number 16 seed, Bodnaruk, the number 9 seed. Can Murata do it again on the blue course? It's a great start from the Japanese rider. Bodnaruk starting to settle now on the red. Bodnaruk building a lead here. Japanese rider just has to take some risk, throw everything at it. Oh, and she gets a little twisted up, and Murata is down. The fairy tale run comes to a close. Vita Bodnaruk from Ukraine is going to ride into the semi-finals. She will race Eliza Fava for a place in the gold medal race. Noa Murata out to the quarterfinal stage. It means a top eight finish for her. And after coming into these finals as the number 16 seed, a great achievement from Noa Murata from Japan. I'm sure she'll still be smiling. But Bodnar looking comfortable. Two quarterfinals gone, two to come. That's the mistake of Murata. Just not able to hold the line, and then you get trapped in the soft snow. Once you're in that soft snow, it's so difficult to get out. These alpine snowboarders like it icy. They like solid snow. Soft conditions are not ideal. You can see the length of the board. 180 plus on the World Cup Tour. Some of the women using over 1.90 meters. Esther Ledecka, famous Czech athlete, alpine skier, and alpine snowboarder, that double gold medalist from Pyeongchang 2018. She actually pushed the sport forward by going up to, I think it was a 1.93. And if you wanted to compete with her, you had to get on the same length board because she generates so much speed. Quarterfinal three underway. Alexa Bullis from the USA on the blue course. Carmen Kainz, the number two seed, on the red. Kainz happy to keep choosing the red course here. And Kainz with that great style. Not too much happening with the upper body. Keeping it calm, that is key. It's all about running a clean edge. And Carmen Kainz through the final turn. She's going to hold up Bullis for the win. Carmen Kainz does it by 0.64. So the Austrian into the semi-finals. And that ends Team USA's chances of a medal here at Gore Mountain today. Carmen Kainz, again, not being fazed by being neck and neck on the top section, taking her time, knowing and trusting that from the midpoint onwards, the red course seems to be the more favorable track. See the Austrian now on the heel edge, balancing through the bumpy, soft snow. Flat light as well. The gates do help with the definition, as do the B-nets, but flat light conditions here today makes it even harder to see those ruts and those bumps, and they can easily catch a rider out. So Noa Kanazawa from Japan on the blue course. Florina Becci from Switzerland on the red. This to race Carmen Kainz in the second of the semi-finals. Riders ready. So here we go. Becci of Switzerland on the red course. Kanazawa on the blue. Tidy start from Kanazawa. Just looking very relaxed and letting that board do the work. So now you have to add that more force. Little stumble from Becci on the red. She hangs on well, great recovery. But Becci in a battle here with Kanazawa, who's not going to wait. More trouble for Becci, oh, trouble for Kanazawa. Well, Becci gets a little lucky. Kanazawa could have had that one. But as soon as the Swiss rider made a mistake, Kanazawa making a mistake of her own. And that put paid to her chances. So Becci taking some risk. And here Becci for the first time on that toe edge gets onto the heel edge. See that picture of concentration. She could see the finish line, maybe just switched off for a moment. The weight trapped a little backwards, and here she goes sideways, and that brings the Japanese rider in. She runs wide here, and if Kanazawa had just been able to hold the line, she might have taken it. But Becci does it by 0.12, getting a little lucky. It was a great day for Switzerland yesterday in women's snowboarding. Livia Tano taking the big air gold. Can Florina Bejci do it again? We've got our final four riders. Eliza Fava up against Vita Bodnarek. Carmen Kainz up against Florina Bejci of Switzerland. Winners go into the big final. Losers of the semi-finals go into the small. A view a little further up the mountain where the fresh snow is still on the trees. Here at Gore Mountain, we are lined up for the first of the women's semi-finals. If you win this, you are walking away with either the gold or the silver medal. You've got to get through this heat. Fava on the red course. Bodnarek for Ukraine on the blue. Fava has looked dialed in once we've got into this elimination, this knockout phase, the finals. And she's dialed in again on the red course. She's been over on the blue earlier on in the rounds, but now finds herself up against the number 9 seed in the semi-finals. That's the way things go sometimes. And Fava still carving nicely. Oh, nearly gets caught on the heel edge, and that's brought Bodnarek back into this race. Bodnarek makes a big mistake. Fava rides through. She's in the big final. Bodnarek goes into the small final. She's still got a chance of a bronze. But it's going to be gold or silver for Eliza Fava. She is smiling, as you'd expect. And she is into the big final, where the gold medals will be decided. Great riding today from Eliza Fava. And the Italian continues the dominance of Italy in this sport. The rider from the University of Novedrate in Como, 20 years old, will race for the gold medal. Just over a second, the difference between the two riders. Second semi-final, Florina Bejci from Switzerland up against Carmen Kainz from Austria. Kainz on the blue course. Kainz on the red course, Bejci on the blue. This to race Eliza Fava of Italy in the big final. Great start from Bejci. She's the number 6 seed. Carmen Kainz the number 2 seed, but Bejci is powering down the hill here. Carmen Kainz knows she needs to find a little more speed. Bejci's pitched forwards, but hangs on. Great recovery from the Swiss rider. We are neck and neck coming into the bottom section. Can Bejci hold on through one of the big ruts? The Austrian with the slight advantage, but Bejci's still not out of it yet. It's going to be a sprint for the line. Who's going to get the place in the big final? Kainz of Austria by a tenth of a second. What a semi-final that was. Both riders in the mix. But Carmen Kainz from the University of Linz in Austria will race Eliza Fava from Italy. Let's see this one again. There was the first of the big mistakes from Bejci on the blue course. It was rock and roll stuff from Bejci all the way down, but she kept herself in the race. Very smooth riding from Carmen Kainz. And maybe if this course was another 50 meters longer, Bejci might have been able to do it. But in the end, she goes into the small final. A tenth of a second, the difference. And that is what a tenth of a second looks like from the finish line camera. So we're all set for the medal runs in the women's event. Have a look at the official lineup. Bear in mind the top seeds will get to choose the course. So Carmen Kainz and Eliza Fava in that gold medal race. Kainz, I think, is going to pick the red course. But Fava, the way she's riding today, is not going to be too bothered. The next race we'll see will be the women's small final. Bodnarek will be on the blue course. A 21-year-old out of the National University of Physical Education and Sport in Kyiv, in Ukraine, has put together a wonderful race today. Can she cap it off with a bronze medal? Baichi has battled hard. Now has a chance over the next 45 seconds or so to walk away with the bronze. Bronze medal race underway at Gore Mountain in the women's parallel giant slalom. Florina Baichi on the red course, Vita Bodnaruk on the blue. Spectacular starts from both riders. This is evenly matched. Baichi now pulling ahead a little on the red course, but Bodnaruk not out of it. Baichi was rock and roll in her semi-final, and now she's a lot calmer, a lot cleaner with the turns on the red course. Bodnaruk just has to keep the pressure on. Big mistake from the Ukrainian, and Florina Baichi comes through and picks up the bronze medal in the women's parallel giant slalom, holding off the challenge of Bodnaruk, the number 9 seed, who'll finish in fourth place. A great effort from her, but it's Baichi who takes home the bronze medal. And the start was so much cleaner this time from Baichi. Just carving nicely on the top section. Bodnaruk was in touch at this stage. We see Baichi dealing with the snow conditions. The best in that small final. And then a quiet celebration as she crosses the line. One race to go for the women. The big final, the gold medal race. And they're lined up in the start gate. Elisa Fava on the blue course. Carmen Kainz from Austria on the red. So often on the World Cup Tour, it's Austria versus Italy in this sport. And at the World University Games, that's what we've got in the big final. Fava has enjoyed riding on the blue course here. Can she carve through to the gold medal? But Carmen Kainz, the number 2 seed, has been almost untouchable all race long. Kainz runs a little wide, that has a huge advantage over to the Italian. Massive mistake from the Austrian, and Elisa Fava just has to stay on her feet, and she will take the gold medal. One gate to go. Elisa Fava from Italy is the 2023 Women's Parallel Giant Slalom gold medalist here at Lake Placid, the FISU World University Games. Carmen Kainz with a huge mistake in the run. Baichi's in to congratulate Fava. Carmen Kainz walks away with a silver. She's still smiling though, but Elisa Fava on the blue course, not putting a foot wrong all race long. Watch Carmen Kainz stand number on the red course, wearing the number 2. She's very much in touch here. Clips the gate with her hand, causes her to lose her balance. And here she's on the heel edge in the soft snow and just cannot engage that toe edge. And in the blink of an eye, Fava able to avoid any mistakes and power away. At that moment, Fava would have seen that mistake and knew that the gold medal was hers. She's able to claim it before the finish line. But great scenes here as Elisa Fava picks up the gold medal for Italy in women's parallel giant slalom. Congratulations to Elisa Fava from Italy. Came in as the number 5 seed and has put together a great race. Walks away with the gold. Kainz the silver for Austria. Baichi for Switzerland, the bronze. Best of the US riders, Bullis in sixth place, doing very well to get into the quarterfinals. Olympia Kwiatkowska finishing in ninth, the number 1 seed. knocked out in the first round. Let's get a look at the highlights of the women's small final first. It was Baechi up against Bodnaruk for the bronze medal, and Baechi on the red course. The great style, nice and clean turns, and she holds off the challenge from the Ukrainian to get the bronze medal. But in the women's final, Kainz of Austria up against Elisa Fava. Fava, perhaps the surprise package today. Put the Austrian under pressure, and Kainz making a mistake halfway down the course, trapped on the heel edge, and out of the race at this point, and not able to get back in course and recover quick enough. So Fava able to cruise through the final few turns and take a remarkable gold medal in the women's parallel giant slalom. So the mascot ceremony coming up next. All these riders that are on the podium, of course, being told, don't go anywhere. Don't go back to the athlete lounge. Stick around because we got the mascot ceremony to come. Coaches and techs start to make their way back down to the bottom of the course. They'll get to work pretty quickly on those boards once they get back to the hotel. Some even do some work up at the mountain for traveling. It's about a 45-minute bus ride for the athletes back to their athlete accommodation. So the women are making their way out for the mascot ceremony. And then in about 20, 30 minutes time, they'll get their medals. The Swiss success continues at Gore Mountain. Great work from Switzerland in the big air and the slope style. And Florina Baechi continues that run with the bronze medal. Carmen Kainz from Austria picks up the silver in this format, particularly in finals where it is a straight knockout. It is so difficult to pick up a medal. Elisa Fava with a huge smile as she picks up the win. The Italians, the Austrians having great programs on the World Cup Tour. One of the riders on the World Cup Tour coming through the military or the police, and they get support to continue their sport, and allows the teams to put together bigger coaching staff as well.